Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our lesson, that is getting to know plant, and in that we have discussed some parts of a plant, and in the last video we have discussed about the parts of a flower. So now let's move for that same point. We'll continue that point. So in the last video we have discussed about the parts of the plant, and also we have done one activity in that we have observed about the transverse section and the longitudinal section of an ovary, in that we have observed the ovules. Okay, now let's see the next one. A flower that consists of all the four whorls is called a complete flower. Okay, now what is mean by the complete flower, or that whorls means what? As we know, there are the four main parts of a plant, that are sepal, petals, pistil and stamen. So if the flower contain all these four parts, then that flower is called as complete flower. For example, mustard and hibiscus. Next one, a flower that does not have all the four whorls is called incomplete flower. So among that four part, if any one part is absent, then that flower is called as incomplete flower. For example, mulberry and date palm. In some flowers like tuber rose, sepals and petals together form tepals. Okay, so there are the certain flowers in that sepals and the petals are togetherly, then that flower is called as what? Tepals. In some plants, stamens are joined to the pistil. For example, in hibiscus. So we have seen in that hibiscus that stamens and pistils are present in the one flower only. Okay. And for example, is that what? Pistil. Stamens are joined to form a staminal tube, and the style passes through this tube. So in the some flower like that, we can see in the hibiscus, the stamens are attached to the pistil. Okay. Next one, the flower that have both stamens and pistil are called bisexual flower. So next one, the flower that have both stamen and pistil are called bisexual flower. So if the flower contain both the reproductive organ, that are stamen and the pistil, then that flower is called as what? Bisexual flower. For example, hibiscus and mustard. Okay, next one, the flower that have either stamen or pistil, then that flower is called what? Unisexual flower. For example, cucumber and bottle gourd. So if the flower contain either stamen or pistil, then that flower is called as unisexual. Uni means what? One. So if the flower is contain only one sexual organ, then that flower is called as unisexual flower. Okay. So up till now we have discussed about complete flower, incomplete flower, bisexual flower and unisexual flower. Now we will move for the last point of the lesson, that is what? Functions of a flower. So as we know, the main function of a flower is to produce fruit and seeds. The fruit and the seeds are formed in the flower by the process of pollination and fertilization. So the main function of a flower is to produce fruits and seeds. The fruits and seeds are performed in a flower by the process, but how that fruits and seeds are get produced in the plant or in the flower? With the help of the process like pollination and fertilization. The transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of a flower is called what? Pollination. Okay, so what we can say that what? See here, these are what? Anthers. Okay, these are what? Anthers. Yellow color, you can see these are what? Anthers. Okay, so transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma, that process is called as what? Pollination. Okay, transfer of pollen grain which are present in the anther, from anther to the stigma, that process is called as what? Pollination. Pollination is done by insect, wind and water. When pollen grain falls on the stigma, they move down through the style and reach the ovary, that we have seen already. Inside the ovary there are the ovule, inside the ovary there are the already ovules. So in that, the male sex cell present in the pollen grain fuse with the female sex cell present in the ovules. Okay, so from the pollen grain, the male sex cell present in the pollen grain which comes into the ovary, and in the ovary there is already ovules, which is nothing but what? Female sex cell. So that both get mix up, that both get fused. So the fusion of the male and the female sex is called fertilization. Okay, so the fusion of the male sex cell means what? Pollen grain. And the fusion of that male sex cell with the female sex cell, which is the female sex cell, ovules. The fusion of the pollen grain and the ovules, it's called what? Fertilization. After fertilization, the ovules grows and becomes seed. Okay, so after fertilization, what happens? The ovules grows and becomes seeds. So that ovules grows and become, they convert it into the seeds. The ovary of a flower grows and becomes fruit. The ovary get increase in a side and they, it becomes what? Fruit with seeds inside it. The fruit protects the seed. The other parts of the flower are dry up and fall. Under suitable condition, that is availability of the water, air and warmth, the seed germinates and become a baby plant. Okay, so under a suitable condition, that is, what is the suitable condition? Availability of the water, air and warmth, and seed get germinate to form a baby plant. Okay, so in this way the flower plays an important role in the formation of seed and the fruits. You know, you are scientist. Okay, so Jagdish Chandra Bose is one of the greatest scientists of all time in India. He graduated from Calcutta University. He achieved doctorate degree in science from London University in 1986. He conducted important research in physics and biology. So he has done a lot of the study in physics and biology. So he was the first scientist to discover that the plants are also living things. So the Jagdish Chandra Bose has discovered that the plants are living things. He conducted many experiments to prove that the plants can feel affection and react to anger and pain. He known as the father of wireless telegraphy. Okay, he invented the radio wave receives, but did not patent it. This machine was used by Marconi to build the radio transmission system specifically designed for wireless communication. Okay, so this is all information given about the Sir Jagdish Chandra Bose. So this is all about today. Today we have finished this lesson. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.